what am I doing? I mean, is this my life? And will it remain like this throughout?
And we are glad that today we have with us the speaker of the hour, that is Ms. Shelley Best, who is an educator, international speaker, host, writer, and social activist, and the list goes on.
Yeah, good evening, Divya, and thanks a lot for inviting me on this prestigious platform. And as the name says, me, myself, mom, M3, you know, it's eye-catching, captivating, and that is the one reason why, you know, it intended me to your organization, because I consider myself as a proud mom, and that it has given me a title, mompreneur, along with my other things also. So really honored to associate it with you. Let me just give you a slight insight about myself. Like, as you have already introduced me in the beginning, that I am an passionate educator. But here I would like to add one thing. Before introducing myself as a passionate educator, I would like to add on a term, learner. Since I am in the education industry from the last 21 years, but that doesn't mean that I have learned enough. I consider myself as a learner, because for learning, it is never an age. Okay, so I believe in keep on learning, getting insights from all my mentors, wherever I go, wherever I talk, you know, I try to gather, you know, some nuggets of wisdom from everybody, from all my mentors. And I believe that the learning process is on and on and on. Along with that, you know, I'm an international host, an international speaker, writer, social activist, and I'm associated with many organizations also. So what I believe that, you know, especially during these times, pandemic and the trying times, I especially believe that it is a blessing in disguise. Because, you know, pre-pandemic, if I try to discover myself, if I go back to flashback, okay, so my life was rigid only with my teaching career, which with a span of say 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., 3 p.m. I was back, and then I was with my family, with my kiddos and all. And then, you know, we used to plan a day, half a day there, then half a day there, whether it consisted of shopping, roaming, and organizing the home and associating with friends, something or the other. The entire agenda of my life was to drop them to the swimming pool or take, or, you know, go for some outing with them. That was a, you know, happy, sweet family. That was my thing. But I don't know whether people associate pandemic with so many negative things or what. For me, pandemic was a blessing in disguise, you know, because it has made me positive in life. Earlier, I was devoting a part of my life to my career. And, you know, I'm not boasting, but yes, today I give minimum 18 hours of my life to all the productive things I am doing, you know. I mean, still today also, till 2 o'clock, I'm busy with my online sessions. That is my classes, you know, senior secondary classes. That is okay. But after 2, then I am busy with doing something or the other. I'm also associated with many NGOs, you know. So I keep on working for some social causes, okay, or either, you know, giving some free services, you know, free community services somewhere, either in the form of some talk show, as I am a COVID-19 talk show host also in one of the platforms. And it comes daily, Monday to Friday. So I keep my slot over there, because, you know, it's something good, you know, when you get associated with all the COVID fighter families, when you interview them, and then when you come to know about their journey, that how they have, you know, fought back this pandemic, and then spreading awareness in the community. So that is something good which I associate myself with. So what I feel then, you know, attending, participating in all webinars, it has given me an insight and energy that life is not stopped. Because frankly, Divya, when it started, I still remember March 2020, 21st March, you know, I was appointed as assistant head coordinator for CBSE 2020-21 examination for English core. And I was preparing the report. I have got, you know, 12 bags. 10 Indians and 2 foreign bags, and I was uploading the marks for CBSE. And then suddenly the CNS came with this, that, you know, it's a national lockdown. Pack up everything. sealed, keep it inside and go home. And I was, I mean, each and every member over there was flabbergasted. How could it be possible? We are doing something so important. We are working on the CBSE result, you know, because as soon as the CBSE result will get uploaded, then we have the DO admissions and all. But then she said, you know, this is the order by respected Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Modi ji. So whatever is declared, we don't know what will happen of the result. Let CBSE, let the government decide, but your job is to seal back everything and go home. And you know, that particular day, I felt as soon, you know, when we packed up, sealed up everything, when I came home, and it was like, you know, because from everywhere, from all quarters, the circular came. My husband will not be attending the office. My kiddos will not be going to school. Even I'm not going to school. Everybody, four of us, you know, at home. And then, you know, the new word, work from home, which, you know, to my knowledge, it existed only with a couple of my friends who worked in the corporate. Okay. So it was like how four of us will survive, you know, 24/7, one home, and then throughout you have to do everything, and then no socializing, nothing. So that was the thing, you know, when it started. But gradually when we picked up, and I noticed that yes, there was certain negativities which was pouring out from all corners, because see, this thing was uncertain. Even we were not having the idea whether it will go for a month, for two, or what. That was there. And then there was a drastic salary cut in all sectors. There was a recession which came out, and not at my place, but yes, many of the educators who are associated with me, I got the news from here and there that yes, there are pink slips which has been showcased, you know, there are people who are losing their job. Then in the corporate world also, you know, I came to know that there are recession, people are losing the job. And then if I talk about ourselves, even me, because, you know, the government decided, the Directorate of Education decided to charge only the tuition fee from the children. So imagine if, you know, the school is getting the tuition fee, how they will be paying the teachers the 100% salary. So obviously it not happened here, but it happened the worldwide, that there was a salary cut for the educators also. But yes, initially, you know, there was a setback. There was a setback because there was hue and cry everywhere. There was depression everywhere. There was negativity. But then I thought, Sherry, it is not happening with you only. It is happening throughout the world. It is happening everywhere. You know, it is a need of the hour. You have to take the charge. And then at that particular moment, you know, Divya, I suddenly felt to rediscover myself. What am I doing? I mean, life has stopped for me. I mean, you know, 24/7, I cannot imagine myself to be at home and after 2 o'clock, what? You know, and then, you know, I indulged myself, or rather I deviated myself, and there was a sea change in my life from there, you know, there was. And yes, one more thing which I would like to tell you is, we have been given enough training through Zoom, through MS Teams, and through Google Meet and all. So of course it was a blessing in disguise that we got, you know, digitally trained, we became tech savvy, and somehow this virtual medium, it has given me a global reach, in fact, because still now I was associated with CBSE only, as I'm the CBSE observer also. So throughout the time, only CBSE meetings, their seminars, and visits also to different CBSE schools and meetings and also, it was associated only at one sector. Okay, but that to only India. But when I entered into this, you know, so gradually and gradually and gradually, you know, the friend circle also increased. I will not boast, but yes, I am really proud that today I am associated with various intellectuals, educators worldwide, and on the same platform. And yes, this virtual medium, it was a blessing in disguise. See, you must be noting that why I'm repeating this phrase again and again, because, you know, this was something positive. It motivated me, it encouraged me, and it has given me a wide reach. And also, you know, I believe that since teaching is a noble profession, if I could do something to spread awareness and to spread my knowledge and expertise to a certain extent, because I am not a big shot, but yes, whatever knowledge if I have, if I can associate it with somebody, then I think it's something good enough. And from there in, you know, nonstop, I'm working and, you know, everything, you know, and I have given myself a shot in writing also. So my first short story was selected and it was published in a Black Sheep community in Amsterdam. So that was the prize winning story, actually, short story. And an article on the teacher community, which I wrote during April 2020, that was featured in EduCloud's Gold Edition, United Kingdom of London. So from therein, it was like, you know, people told me, you know, you have a good flair for writing, so you should continue. And there, you know, the journey as a writer also started. And then I started writing so many articles related to discipline, related to motivation and work-life balance. And then gradually, you know, I started featuring in some magazine, in a sort of an interview, something or other. And then it was never, I never looked back. But all the more, you know, it gave me such positive insight that yes, life is too short. We never know what's gonna happen tomorrow. And yes, this is the new normal. I discovered this new term also, the new normal. Now, we are human beings. We need to adjust. We cannot droop and sulk at one corner and then keep on sulking. This happened with me. No, never, never. You should have a never die attitude. Okay. And also fear is the biggest teacher, what I believe. At times, maybe there are people, and at times with us also, we might have also, you know, come across failures. But let me tell you one thing, Divya, that failure is such a good thing which happens with you, because unless and until you don't have failure, you cannot taste success in life, you know. So it's good because life is not a bed of roses and nobody's perfect. We can't award ourselves 10 on 10. Even we might be full of shortcomings. Even, you know, there are sometimes positives and negatives happening in their life. But I believe this is a phase and we should continue with our journey.
So true, because I feel that, you know, in this pandemic we have rediscovered ourselves, and this pandemic has brought us all together.
Yeah.
Like countries, areas, and you know, castes and everything. But we got all together. We are really glad you're sharing this with us, because I feel that homemakers were the ones whose actual work got recognized when everybody was at home. Yeah. Because they contribute a lot, but so that. And that, you know, recognition was not being given. And yeah, obviously being a working lady and, you know, finding home is a tough job.
Yeah. And one more thing, Divya, which I have noticed, it did not happen with my family. I believe it has happened everywhere. Not all fathers, you know, because of the corporate job, because that is the demand of the situation, you know. All of these fathers, they were traveling abroad, or they had such hectic schedule that they were not giving time at home, you know, because 9-to-5 job maybe, and late timing, something or the other, and they were living life out of suitcase. But yes, this pandemic, certainly you have used the correct word, it gave us the quality time. It gave us the quality, each and everybody, you know, we were so united and we were sitting together, even discussing with all the stories of the children. We were sharing so much of it there. And also, I think the world had tried new recipes also. You know, there were various recipes which was tried and it was even shared on the family group everywhere. So somehow, you know, family which eats together, I believe, stays together. So that is something warm, some warmth which we all got, you know, all mom, dad, kiddos sitting together, even watching movies together, playing together, doing some creative piece of work, maybe the artwork, drawing, singing, dancing, whatever. But then we were doing it together. So that quality time, it somehow gives, you know, a spirit to yourself, a boost to yourself. And that pandemic phase, you know, it kept on and on and on. And yes, 2021, especially April 2021, when the second wave came, you know, it was at the peak. And I'm very sorry to report, yes, many of us, we lost our near and dear ones. Okay, that was the most tragic phase which happened, you know, because 2020 pandemic, it was okay. It was lockdown and people lost jobs. We talked about the recession. We talked about the financial crisis. But then still, we were together. There was not much harm which caused. But second wave, certainly there was a drop. There was a drop. And but then also, I mean, whoever talks with me, whoever, I try to motivate everything. See, it is not in our hands. We don't know what it's going to have it in the future also. So whatever is happening, we have to flow in that particular flow. And let's carry on. Let's adapt ourselves to that, because everything will be good, what I believe.
And like you mentioned that, you know, it was a drastic change for you as well, you know, by that office and then, you know, working at home along with the family. So how did you, like, I'm sure that there would be many challenges that you might have faced, you know, wherein both the life has an important call and you have to decide, you know, where to give importance and which call to, you know, attend and everything. So how did you manage to do that?
See, to be very frank, as I told you, pre-pandemic, my phase was yes, because that was a call which I had taken, that my first half was dedicated to my career and the second half should be dedicated only to my family and nobody else. Then I had to take the charge at yes, how I have to plan my second half, what I have to do. So my priority was only my kids or whatever, my life revolved everything, but I was not doing anything positive for myself. Okay, but it was, see, I kept myself only at the fourth place, at the fifth place, like my family was the first priority. Now also my family is the first priority. But now I think, can I know who Shelly is? Can I know my hidden talents? Can I know my hidden potentials, which I think after marriage, maybe I had subdued that, yes, I am along with that career, I wanted to, you know, balance my life as a very good wife, as a very good mom, and as a very good friend to somebody. So that was my life. But then, yes, one fine day during pandemic only, you know, I thought, what am I doing? I mean, the life has stopped. And will it be like this for future, forever? And, you know, along, suppose in case if I can manage, why can't I? And then, you know, it was a gradual process. It was a gradual process. I tried and I enjoyed, you know, when I thought, yeah, this is the area which I was not aware of. And when I started gaining knowledge, gaining insights from something or from somewhere, and all those positive vibes started coming to me. And then I said, there are many areas wherein I can learn. And there is a hope of improvement also. And everybody can, you know, work for improvisation also. So I thought, why not to empower myself? Okay, being positive everywhere by balancing my life also, my family also, my work also. And I gave it a challenge to myself. Shelly, can you do it? And then I said, maybe, let me try to be very honest. And the journey started like this, you know. I tried and then, you know, it was good, you know. And I started getting the positive reviews, there were people who said they liked my writing, they liked my speech, they loved listening to me. And it was like this, oh, is that so? Okay, is that so? Okay, I never knew like this. I never knew. Okay. And then, you know, people around me, my well-wishers and everybody, they motivated me. No, you have to keep on. Because I thought probably I will be doing it for a shorter period of time. Okay. Till the pandemic was there. So I thought maybe for a month. Because, you know, the declaration was coming from the government that lockdown is extended for another month. So I thought maybe I will do it for a month only and then I'll get back to my original life, you know. But it got extended and extended, and my journey also, it got extended and extended. But yes, when I loved so many things, so I thought if I could be an inspiration to somebody, if I'm able to influence any life. And then, you know, when somebody calls me up and say, Shelly ma'am, we are not able to pay you for this particular session or something, and because of pandemic and because of this global crisis, are you able to do it free of cost? And I said, why not? if I have the time and if I have the capability and if I have the zeal to do it, because I've considered teaching always as a noble profession and as an educator, if I can be of a certain small help to the community, I would like to go forward. And this is how, you know, and this is, I believe now this is a never-ending process. And I would like to continue it forever and ever, because even I am learning a lot. It's not like that you go and you speak somewhere or something and then, but then you get to learn so many things from the people around. Because if I talk about my mentors, okay, then yes, my mentors are somebody who is in their late 50s, in their late 60s, and I love interacting with them, because each and every time when I meet them on any platform, you know, there is a galaxy of intellectuals from all over the world, and then there is enough space for you to even learn. So I believe this is something very positive, and this is what I want to even tell people also around, that yeah, they should not be depressed, they should be motivated, they should be charged up in their life.
That's lovely. And I like the space that you have shared, that, you know, like I said, that we have rediscovered ourselves.
Yes,
you never knew that this is what you had the talent, and you know, people would be appreciating or it would be recognized. And then you came to know, and you said that you sent me for a month or so, and now you are actually pursuing that passion. So that is what, you know, most of the women out there need to hear, because self-doubt is the biggest fear, which is stopping them, you know, from moving ahead. And that is the actual motto of entry, to, you know, encourage and, you know, yes, each of the women who are community, who are members, that, you know, if she can do, you can too. So we are glad that you have shared the story, and this in tough time of pandemic, because the world was ending, that is what people thought. And to, you know, keep a balance in the stress and the depressing, and to find something, you know, to help and to love.
Yeah, again. Yeah. And one more thing, see, when somebody, you know, at times when we are in a comfortable zone, okay, I am from a good family. My husband is earning good. I've got two small kids. I have a decent home. I have a decent career. So sometimes it feels, why should I work? Everything is rosy around me. And I am a sort of a woman. I mean, I will not go for more and more and more. You know, my dreams are not that big. And it was a very comfortable life for me. And it could have been the same life in the future also. But then, as I told you, suddenly one fine day, I rediscovered, I mean, what am I doing? I mean, is this my life? And will it remain like this throughout? So I said, yes. So that was the introspection rather I had one day, that no, Shelley, this is not you. You have to take out the real Shelley, the real mom, you know? And that is what, how the journey began. And now also the process is on.
That's lovely, because that, you know, you motivated yourself.
The message which I want to pass to all the moms is that optimism means better than reality, and pessimism wins worse than reality. There are so many difficult things, you know, we are living through in the world today. So many horrible events, but we cannot let them stop us. Now, no matter what happens, I feel you all proud moms should move forward with optimism and not get totally sideswiped by anybody. No pessimist ever discovered the secrets of the stars, or sailed to an uncharted land, or opened a new heaven to the human spirit. So, you know, at times what we believe, that we do not need magic to change the world. We carry all the power we need inside ourselves already. We have the power to imagine better. So, you know, rediscover yourself. The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands at times of challenge and controversy. So hard times don't create heroes. It is during the hard times when the hero within us is revealed. And I discover that all the proud women around us, you know, we are all proud enough, and we will certainly come victoriously, but only. The motto is that, as the symbol right now on my screen is me, myself, mom, M3. So you should be proud of yourself. You should be proud of your identity, and you should be a proud mom all around. And yes, certainly, Divya, I'm like the tagline of your creative busy mom. Of course, I liked it. Yes, I'm proud that I am busy. And if I can make the others also busy, and if I am able to put a smile on somebody's face, a cheer on somebody's face, that is the best thing which I have done ever in my life.